Hello everyone and welcome back. I'm Brad and this is World of Warcraft Legion. I'm on my Warlock tonight and we are in the Broken Shore and I am trying my cast route for the very first time ever. I've got a bunch of casters, but this will be the first one I've ever tried on the Broken Shore. So we'll see how well I do. I'm not sure how useful I'm going to be. We shall see. Let's go after the big boss guy.
This one's mine!
I have to just remind myself that I have, I'm running Affliction right now, so I can, tank a little bit better with these bosses. It'll take a bit longer to kill the enemies, but I'm not too worried about that. It's all about surviving on the Broken Shore. Surprisingly, he didn't do that much damage to my Infernal. I'm a little shocked. I'm just down on the coastline, just to the west of the main base. There's that little quest, the little road quest there, where I have to disrupt crystals. And the boss tent happened to be up inside the cave as well, so I just did both. Lots of drains and sucking out the enemy's souls, and I don't mind at all. I need the upgrades as well, so it's gonna help if I get a lot of drops. I just got a ring, which is good.
I have never understood how anyone could find charm in those distasteful creatures. Let us turn our attention to more pressing matters.
Okay, let's get out of here while we can. Before I aggro another enemy. Yes. There are bosses up all over the zone again, which is fine by me. I love fighting the bosses. It's just going to be a little bit different fighting them on my Warlock. We'll head down into the main, I like to call it the main aggro area, because just down here there's just so many enemies. Let's go after Fellbringer's Zarthok. We could also do Fellfire and Ice, which is on the coastline. I'm curious to see how I'll hold up against Marthok. If I don't get dismounted on the way. Okay, he should be around here somewhere. There he is. Uh-oh. He's moving into aggro territory. Get rid of some of these guys. I don't need too many extra guys. Alright, let's go after him. I keep forgetting he's got two followers that follow him around.
Your world crumbles around you, mortals. We cannot be stopped!
Ah, I forgot that he does ground targeting like crazy. This is not bad. It's actually a lot easier than my tanks. I'm a little shocked. My Infernal is taking all the damage from him, but he's not really hurting at all. I guess most of his attacks are AoEs, and my Infernal is basically immune to those. Alright, next. Bone Crawler Grub? I have to kill 50 bone crawlers? I've never seen that world quest before. Let's go down here and check that out.
Champion, the very land is rotting beneath our feet. Manifestations of decay proliferate at every turn. They must be eradicated.
Why is that mature bone crawler not doing anything? Oh, this is going to be pretty easy with my AoEs. I think I was out of the world quest zone area. Well, that wasn't nice. That would have been a lot more fun if I was in the zone. Let's see. I have to get a treasuring key. I spoke to the I still have to kill 14 more grubs, and I also spoke to the female goblin back at the base to look for the treasure. And I wonder if it's at the same place. I'm not entirely sure if it is. Yeah, it is. It should be in the exact same spot, I think. Yeah, there it is. Well, I got the key before he did, but he's still gonna give me a useless treasure.
Culling the numbers of those vile worms helps restore the balance on these shores. You have my thanks, hero.
Oh my god, so many of these bone crawlers. I've got to get out of here. There's so many. I forgot that every time I kill a guy, they explode on me. Well, they don't explode on me. Ew. Let's go after Malorus the Soul Keeper. I think I should... Oh, I'm gonna aggro regardless. Eh, not a big deal. I could take them all out with my AoEs. Alright, here we go. Go after him, buddy. Whoa. I didn't realize he drops prisons. Oh, he killed my demon. Didn't even realize he killed him so quickly. I may need help. No. I really have to watch my demon super careful. Whoa. He takes off about 50% of my demon's health with one of his abilities. This guy's dangerous. So basically what I'm doing, you may not be able to see it in the video, is I'm draining my own health to heal my pet. And it's all because this guy is doing a huge number on my pet. So the red beam is me siphoning my life into my demon. And the purple is me draining the life from my enemy. Whoa. Really tricky. Now another player shows up to help out. Showed up a little late, buddy. I was almost done. Well, let's see. Broodmother Nyx. She's in a cave. Should be able to get to her up this way. Now I've got a shield on, so I should be able to stay mounted. As long as my shield stays up. The cave's over here, I believe. Yeah, here it is. Hello, Broodmother. I'm gonna introduce you to my Infernal, because he's just cool like that. Well, I didn't aggro any of her pets, nice. Oh, nope, one's gonna come into view. So the purple explosions you're seeing is one of my abilities, where I can... She's not doing much damage to my pet. I think all of her abilities are AoEs. My Infernal generates an AoE, a flame AoE, and then I do AoEs on top of that with my Seed of Corruption. Easily, at least so far. Whoa. long as I can keep myself up, I should be fine. So my corruption that I drop on enemies is permanent, and then on top of that, if I drop a Seed of Corruption on a target and the Seed of Corruption explodes, it puts corruption on everything that's hit by it, and since my corruption is permanent, everything that gets hit by it has a permanent corruption on them. So it kind of just, it helps me out with my AoE DPS. Let's take a flight. We'll go to Vengeance Point, and then we'll do the Ancient Bones quest. There we go. So now we're on the north side of the zone. There's a world quest just up the hill here. This one can be tricky if you're not careful.
It is said that the remains of those buried in these ruins have magical properties. Let us put these rumors to the test. Recover their ancient bones and place them upon the ruined altar.
With my affliction warlock, I have three dots that I apply. And then I have my unstable affliction, which it is a dot, but it's kind of like, almost like a nuke dot, in my opinion. Oh, somebody else aggroed him. Where are the bones? Send my pet down after him.
I need a target.
I was hoping I'd be able to reach him, but... Whoa, what's that? Oh no, the portal's open here as well.
Secrets before you die.
Ah, oh, she charmed me. No. Oh, they killed my Inferno. Damn these friggin' things. Let's grab a bone while I'm down here.
I need to target something first.
Tell me your secrets before you die.
Gosh. No. Too many. They almost drop these eyes, which do these beams from just turn around in the air for 360 degrees, but they keep going. If you're fighting three of them at a time, they could drop nine, and they could kill you so easily if you get stuck in between them. Because they bounce you around, they have a knockback, but if you're stuck in between a whole bunch of them, they'll knock you back into each one, causing like a ping pong effect, and then you're screwed. I don't know if this is an opportune time or an inopportune time that the portals opened up while I was here.
My shuttle is carrying
Kill you! Take your things!
Demonic Lieutenant's up. Where is he? Is that the Lieutenant? It's an elite mob. It's funny, my Infernal versus their Infernal. They both do AoEs, so they're not really doing much damage to each other. Because they're immune to them. Because of my artifact, I tend to see ghostly images of the recently dead, deceased. So that's why you're seeing these ghosts just standing around, because they're people I've killed. Oh, there he is, Skulgaloth. I wonder if I could tackle him. He's only 110, but he's a silver mob. I think I'm gonna go after him and see. Let's go for it. If this guy is like any of the other ones, he's gonna have a targeted AoE, so I have to watch for that. Wow, he's strong. Bad so far. This guy is huge. Oh, crap. Pet's dead. Okay, I have other players here. Basically, with the Warlock, if you've never played a Warlock before, with an Affliction Warlock, I just basically have to keep my dots up at all times, or my DPS plummets. So I constantly have to watch. Kill my demon. Ah, I killed him again. I'd be so dead if there were not other players here.
I need a ton.
Oh, I got new leggings too. Nice. Hey, I'm still not done with the bones. I need two more sets of ancient bones. There's one. And I still have to put them on top of the altar. Oh, the altar's down here, that's right.
How magnificent! Enjoy your creation before the magic fades.
Okay, and now we'll fly back to the main base. I have to turn in the one quest to the little goblin, and I have the completion of the Legion Fall quest.
I've sacrificed everything. What have you given?
So we'll just fly over there really quick.
I've sacrificed everything. What have you given?
I love the way she talks. So cool. I honestly, as much as this expansion has so many demons, I don't get tired of demons. I want there to be an even greater variety of demons. Even though there's quite a good variety now. They've added the Inquisitors and a bunch of other ones. Even the demon Murlocs are cool. Okay, first we'll come back to this guy. Got the supplies, now someone needs to decide what to do with them. Looks like it's your call, being the Netherlord and all. Time to pick a building to focus on. Okay, so basically I have to pick one of three buildings to put my supplies in. I don't have to continue doing it. Not contribute one of buildings under construction. Interesting.
The Burning Legion will fall.
Okay, so this Maiev, she's just telling me that there's going to be invasions across the Broken Isles.
Back to your duties.
I have to go and work on those invasions.
Must be stopped.
And Archmage Khadgar, he's just talking to me about how I have to go in to the Tomb of Sargeras and go after Mephistroth and kill him.
Trust in yourself, champion.
Illidan, convey the Aegis of Agrimmar to the cathedral. I will descend into the tomb with Khadgar and hunt the monster down.
You haven't seen this before, I'll just let you.
The reign of destruction will soon be ended.
You are too quick to trust Illidan, Prophet. I will ensure he fulfills his duty.
Right. We have our orders. Good luck.
I don't know. I trust the Prophet more than anybody else. Okay, let's go down to the little female goblin, who's constantly looking for treasure. And we'll see, this one shouldn't give me anything but artifact power, but that's fine. I need the artifact power regardless.
Yeah, what do you want?
She's kind of like an excuse to do a really simple quest on the Broken Isles that'll give you artifact power, like more artifact power than you would typically get in like doing a champion run or something. Even though the Order Hall champion quests are pretty good for artifact power now. But with that, we are done. We're about to come up on 30 minutes, so we're going to call it there. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.
If you like this video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe for more videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.